Normally I develop all my own material, because I discovered that for the most part, great scripts don't land on your desk. But this came out of the blue from Peter Chernin, and who, when Peter Chernin sends you a script, you pay attention, you read it immediately, and got me absolutely going and wound up, and I climbed into it and said, I'm gonna make this my next movie. Christian and I met just to chat, and we chatted and said, let's find something. 6 years later, I finally called him up and said, I want you to play Moses, and he went, oh no. But then he read it and went, you know what, this is pretty good. And we climbed into that. And he's always good in everything, but he has really matured now and come into his own and is particularly magnificent as Moses. Joel's really good. I always remember that, for a guy on the one hand be saying, right, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna read the scenes in total Aussie, then suddenly change and become somebody else. And he gets it. Everything is detailed. Everything has to be built or made. Can you actually come up with, can I do this? Because if I do that, that's really insane. But we want a bit of insane. Can I ram a chariot into a chariot? Can there be a collision? Can that, without killing the king? And we work it out. Gladiator was a very contained story of revenge. Proud, although I am, of it. Very proud of that, actually. Because I think we set, when I decided to do Gladiator, I think there was a lot of sniggering that I was going to do a sword and sandal movie with guys walking around in skirts and stuff like that. And what it did, it opened up the whole universe of everything. Everything now, gods and kings and God knows what else is happening right now. I think it's really because of what Russell did in Gladiator. I really do. The plagues evolve and God's retribution coming in fundamentally to say, this is going to take a generation to do what you're doing, which is fundamentally turn the population against Ramses, because it can only be the population will make Ramses toe the line, and then you go straight into the people going into major revolution. They crash the granaries, take the grain, and outside are troops of Ramses who shoots them down. So now you have the beginning of the people turning against him.